Hi Maria, thank you very much for joining me today. This is part of the INWED 2020 celebrations and we're here to talk about your fantastic achievements here at UCL Engineering. So perhaps we could start by learning a little bit about your background and what you study.
So I'm now finishing my master's engineering degree in computer science, a subject that focuses on problem solving and is widely applicable in many current topics. It does not only include learning how to code or solving computing problems and designing new software, but also it's about developing new ways to use technology. It can be applied to a variety of domains like data analysis, graphics or robotics, but also to every other domain such as education or medicine.
So who or what inspired you to want to study engineering?
While at school, there were a lot of girls in my science classes. I noticed that there was a greater imbalance at the more professional level. Yeah. I knew relatively fewer women who studied engineering or were already professional engineers. As my family and teachers have always been supportive of my decisions, I pursued computer science with a personal aspiration of using it to give back to the community in any way possible. My parents and brother are actually engineers and encouraged me a lot. And my mom in particular has been a great example that women can thrive in engineering. My sister, who is a passionate researcher in statistics and artificial intelligence, has also been a huge source of motivation throughout my life, especially during my studies.
Sounds like you've got some great role models there. What's your favorite part about studying engineering?
I love developing new technology, which can then be applied to almost anything. I'm especially intrigued by the application with a social aspect, such as those in healthcare. Also, I enjoy studying imaging, statistics, and AI, which combined with computer science can help devise safe and transparent algorithms that are good for all of us, for society. Similarly to advancements in computer science having changed modern communication, emerging technology in CS can be applied to medicine and can revolutionize diagnosis, improve the health system, and contribute towards personalized treatments.
What's the most valuable lesson you've learned in your studies so far?
I realized the level of impact that any new tool or technology can have on the world. Our problem-solving skills and analytical thinking can be applied to anything we want, but it is wonderful when this is used to make the world better. At the same time, this brings a lot of responsibility because of the high impact that these technologies have on a societal and real-world level. Another very important lesson I've learned is how important it is to invest in the future generations. This past year, I have been leading and organizing engineering workshops to schools all around London as part of the Engineers Without Borders Society here at UCL. We have already seen the difference that it makes to students who have not considered this career path. We are very proud of engaging over 800 students this year alone in our workshops. It is wonderful to see that a different approach can motivate the students to be more creative and open to all subjects. After an hour-long interactive workshop with the students, they get so much new knowledge and fresh excitement for STEM subjects. For us, it is also beautiful to see how many young students choose to deal with global challenges in these workshops and use their creativity to solve problems that affect not only them, but everyone in the world, regardless of their origin or background.
Can you describe a typical day in the life of an engineering student, perhaps pre-lockdown?
For the past 4 years that I have been a student at UCL, a large part of my day is spent on campus, either at lectures, lab sessions, or at the library. Apart from these, I have weekly meetings with my supervisor and the committee of Engineers Without Borders Society. I always spend my lunch break with friends and then continue with other university commitments, such as group projects. In the evenings, I usually do paperwork as part of organizing the outreach activities. My personal favorite days are those with an outreach activity at a school. This includes traveling to school with the rest of the volunteers and all the materials needed to deliver a fun workshop to students aged 8 to 16.
So how has the current COVID-19 situation affected your work-life balance?
The COVID outbreak affected us towards the end of term 2 which is a time when all students are working on their assignments. The uncertainty that accompanies this situation was overwhelming to me as a final year student, but I continued to work on my dissertation and other assessments in order to keep a more normal schedule. Even though it took a while to get accustomed to the new normal, I consider myself to be lucky as all my work can be done with a laptop and an internet connection. On a more positive note, this outbreak has strengthened my desire to apply computer science in the health sector, because the academic and industrial community can use this situation and the technological advancements to help the general public. For example, we can sequence the genome of COVID, analyze patient information to understand the impact of COVID on physical and mental health. We can study the spread of the virus through network theory or create an app to find volunteers in the neighborhood to help those in need.
And finally, what advice would you give a younger person or even your younger self who wanted to study or work in a STEM-related field?
It is important to understand that our journey in school, university, and life in general will come with many obstacles, but we should remember that each stage is a unique learning opportunity. Let's all be persistent and motivated in working towards our goals, because hard work combined with a true passion will definitely result in beautiful outcomes.
That's great. That's great advice. Thank you very much for joining me today, Maria.
Thank you.